Adiós, adiós.
Buenas noches.
Mira, por favor.
Buenas noches, ¿me escucha? Hola. Buenas noches.
Último que van a hacer.
Hello, Jason.
Hello.
Cállate.
Good evening, Miss Ada Azucena. Do you listen to me?
Good evening.
Okay, perfect. No problem.
No.
Okay, we're going to wait for a while. Vamos a esperar un ratito que se incorporen los otros compañeros, okay?
Okay.
Perfecto.
Thank you.
My pleasure, my pleasure. Good evening, Mr. Ramirez. Good evening, Ms. Girón. The microphone. I don't listen to you. El micrófono. Okay, perfect.
Good evening.
Buenas noches. Vamos a esperar un par de minutos mientras se incorporan los otros compañeros, ¿de acuerdo?
Sí.
Ok, perfecto.
Thanks.
Good evening, Ms. Alguero. Okay. Good evening, Miss Yesenia Enriquez. I have Miss Ana González, Miss Ada Azucena Cáceres, Mr. Alberto Ramírez, Miss Heidi Eugenia, Miss Verónica Yesenia Enríquez Arevalo, and Miss Xochitl Girón, right?
Yes.
Okay. In just a few minutes, we're going to get started. In this new month, the month of the women, right? March. Because remember, on March the 8th, we celebrate the International Women's Day. Yes? Yes, that's it. Okay, good. So, let me see who else. Actually, most of you are ladies, right? The ones who are right now in the group. Okay, so it is exactly the time. So we're going to get started with you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Because it is exactly the time, we are going to get started. And while we get acquainted, mientras nos conocemos, the other partners are going to join to the group, okay? To the virtual class. Los otros compañeros se nos van a unir al grupo. My name is Irma Carballo. I'm going to be with you in this module from today on. A partir de hoy voy a estar con ustedes, ¿verdad? En este curso. And I hope that you can learn. If you don't understand something that I say, please don't hesitate to ask me. No duden en preguntarme, ¿de acuerdo? If you consider that I am speaking too fast, please tell me, teacher, wait, too fast, okay? Because sometimes we get excited. Algunas veces nos emocionamos mucho. And then we start talking and talking, but you are like, oh my gosh, what is she saying? Ay, Dios mío, ¿qué está diciendo ella? Okay, so feel free to tell me and to ask me whatever you need to know, okay? So, as I was telling you, my name is Irma Carballo, and I'm glad to be with you, okay? Because, how can I tell you? It is nice to be at this time, before vacations, right? Before summer vacations, because vacations are going to be at the end of this month and at the beginning of the next month, which is April, right? Okay, so here we go. And let's see, let's get started. You are in, we're going to admit. Some of your partners. Okay, hello. To the other people who have been admitted. Okay, perfect. So as I was telling you that you are in module number 4. So I have some questions for you. Were all of you together in module number 3? Todos ustedes estuvieron juntitos en el módulo número 3.
Not me.
No.
No,
not
of you.
Okay. No.
Usted la teacher. This module with the group.
I didn't.
And also Ana González, this is your first time with this group. Yes.
That's correct.
Okay, who else? Freddy's? Is this your first time with this group or you were together before? ¿O estuvieron juntos antes?
En mi caso,
¿sí?
Vengo igual que Ada. Nosotros estábamos en otro grupo. que es la única que reconozco yo ahorita, Ana Azucena.
Desde noviembre.
Nos vamos a conocer. Ajá,
desde noviembre es que no teníamos nosotros ningún grupo.
That's amazing because you're going to make new friends. Okay,
yeah.
Es fabuloso porque va a conocer nuevos amigos, nuevos compañeros. Okay? So, let's see. Probably you need to practice a lot, yes? Because remember, some of you since November didn't practice. Okay, algunos de ustedes no practican desde
November,
since last November. Okay, so here we go. Let's get started first. And let's begin by sharing. I'm going to share my screen with you. And you tell me if by any reason you don't see my screen, you tell me. Si por alguna razón no miran lo que les estoy compartiendo en la pantalla, me lo hacen saber, ¿verdad? Porque algún problemita puede haber y lo solucionamos a tiempo. ¿De acuerdo? Okay.
Okay.
Si por alguna razón no me escuchan, me lo hacen saber también para que yo me dé cuenta. Y si a ustedes se les olvida activar el micrófono, también les vamos a hacer saber para que ustedes, pues, activen el micrófono, ¿verdad? Okay. Yes, Freddy, tell me, please.
Good night. My name is Freddy Rivas. In the first time I met with
in this group.
You in this class, in group. It's my first time using this phone for communication in class.
Oh, this is your first virtual class. Okay, yes. Welcome.
Thank you. I want to be sure can hear me and can see me and participate with you. I'd really like to be with you. Yeah.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Freddy Rivas. We can listen to you perfectly and we can listen to you, okay? In case that we don't see you, we're going to let you know, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
I want to close the...
I'm giving access to some people. Okay. Let me see who else is in. Okay. Now you are 12. Okay, so here we go. We can see our faces. And as I was telling you, well, I was about to share my screen with you, but some other people are here. And we're going to try to get together. The first thing first, okay? We're going to try to get acquainted. You know the meaning of acquainted. Nos vamos a conocer, because as some of you have told me, como algunos de ustedes me han dicho, no todos han estado juntos antes. Yes, this is my first time with you people, okay? Esta es la primera vez que estoy con ustedes. I don't know you and you don't know me. So it is a pleasure for me to be with you. Okay. And here we go. Let's see who else wants to get in. Nobody else. Okay. So I'm going to share with you my screen a little bit about generalities. And I'm going to share my PPT, my PowerPoint, okay? And here we go. This is video conference number one. Our sessions are going to be named video conference, module 4, level beginner. And here I have my agenda. First, greetings and general information. As I told you before, sharing agenda, objective, warming up, it is just a simple activity so we can get, you know, into the mood of studying. Describing different features about the products that people purchase. You know, features are characteristics, yes? Something, some details about something in the product that people purchase with money, yes? Now we purchase online because of the pandemic 19. And you're going to be asking and answering questions. And we're going to be using how much, how many, and the wrap up. So here we go. The objective for this class is that you describe different features about the products that people purchase. Purchase is a kind of synonym for buy, yes? And the class objective. Do I have any volunteer to help me reading the class objective? Who wants to practice reading? Who wants to practice reading?
I do.
Okay.
Please. The class objective, describe different features about products that workplace purchase.
Very well. Okay, I'm going to stop sharing my screen because there are some more people over here. Okay, somebody else wants to. Yo estoy bajo un celular, me salgo nuevamente. Okay, listen, if you have a problem, you have to get out from the class and then you get back. No problem at all, okay? There is no problem. And then you continue. Okay. So, okay. Good. And now I'm going to continue sharing my screen. But it is 8 and 10, so I'm going to start with the attendance. Yes? Because remember that we are going to have your attendance. I'm going to be checking your attendance 3 times. At the beginning, in the middle of the class, and at the end, which is at 8. So we need to try to be on time. Necesitamos estar a tiempo. At 9, because it is the middle of the class, and at 10. At the time when we say goodbye. Okay, when we say goodnight because we go to sleep, then I'm going to be calling your attendance. But when I call your names, I need you to activate your camera. Yes? Okay, so here we go. Ada Azucena is here, right? You say here or present. Okay, you activate your microphone. You say here, quiere decir aquí estoy. Present, presente, ¿de acuerdo?
Okay.
¿Sí? Ana Claudia.
Present.
Perfect. Andrés Alberto. Andrés Alberto Orellana.
Good night. Hi, teacher.
Where are you? Oh, here. Perfect.
Hello, everybody.
Okay, excellent. That's the attitude. You need to... That is a must. Eso es obligación a esta hora, ¿verdad?
Yeah.
César Humberto López. César, are you here, César? César, are you here? No.
Okay.
Fátima.
Coméntela, bien, no se la ve.
Fátima Efigenia López, not yet.
No lleva.
Francisca Delmira. Not yet. Freddy, yes, you're here.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yes, okay, thank you. Heidi Eugenia?
Right here.
Okay, Heidi. Okay. Antonio? Hugo? Hugo, Antonio.
Creo que él es el que puso en el chat. Que tenía
problemas con el teléfono. Uh-huh. Oh, sí, pero sí logró entrar, ¿verdad? Y luego ya se va a incorporar nuevamente. Ok, Karen Stephanie Flores. Not yet. Liliana Melissa.
Present.
Ok, Liliana Melissa. Lorena Guadalupe.
Here, teacher.
Oh, hello.
Hello,
thank you. María Milagro. María Milagro, not yet. F Fatima, where are you, Fatima? Ah, waiting room. Okay. I'm going to admit, Hugo, admit, and Jason, admit. Okay, so here we go. Maria Milagros? Maria Milagros, not yet. Karen Stephanie? Fatima? Hello, Fatima?
Hello.
Ah, you were having kind of problems, right, with the connectivity. And Hugo, are you back? Did you solve the problems? ¿Solucionó los problemas, Hugo? Hugo, con el teléfono. Lo acabo de admitir, no sé qué le habrá pasado. Okay, María Milagros is not here. Mauricio Alberto Ramírez.
Present.
Okay, thank you.
Present teacher.
Yes, okay. Here, okay. Very loud. Patricia Janet Barrera. Not yet. Sandra Carolina Perdomo. Sandra Carolina, not yet. Verónica Yesenia. Hello, Verónica Yesenia.
Present teacher.
Oh, okay.
Present teacher.
Yes, Verónica Yesenia. Excellent. Wendy Patricia. Wendy, not yet. Xochitl? Yes, very early. Yolanda Cristina?
I am here, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Yolanda. Okay, very well. So let's get started. Probably later on, your partners are going to join. And I'm going to continue sharing my screen with you, okay? And this is what we were practicing, because one of you practiced reading the objective. Now, who wants to help me? I need a volunteer to help me reading the competency for today. Okay, who wants to?
I am teacher.
Okay, Annie, please, Ana Gonzalez.
A competency to describe different features about the products that any workplace purchase.
Very good. Okay, so you remember, could you please close your microphone? Please. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Now, greetings and general information. As I promised at the beginning, today we're going to be switching from English into Spanish and so on in order to have all the information clear. I have already greeted you. And the general information is greetings and introductions. Okay, this is the first part. We're going to be introducing one another, getting acquainted. Why? Because you were not together. And this is my first time with you. And it is the first time that you're taking classes with me. Attendance, cameras move on, and blah, blah, blah. Okay, so thank you. I appreciate that you are early in class, and Inglés Corporativo is really, really glad that you are beginning this new trip, this new adventure in module number 4. So remember, practice makes perfect. You need to be practicing actively, okay? Every single day we are here, and you are making a sacrifice at this time in order to improve the language, okay? Your target language is English, and you need to practice as much as possible, okay? Very well. The general information for the class. Attendance, you know that it is mandatory. It is an obligation to be in class. You need to be in class every single day. That is the spirit, that is the objective, but if by any reason you cannot make it one day, remember that you need to have the 80% of the attendance to the video conferences. necesitan tener el 80% de las asistencias a las videoconferencias. Yes or no? Are we clear? ¿Estamos claros en eso? Perfect. Very well.
Yes, it is clear.
Okay. And remember, I am so sorry, but I am not allowed to give you permission to sit in classes. Y lo siento porque, yo no estoy autorizado, ni nadie de los administrativos me ha dicho, por favor. Gracias. Como les decía, yo no estoy autorizada para darle permiso a nadie de faltar a clases, ni tampoco los administrativos, porque es una beca y el compromiso adquirido con INSAFORP es, ¿verdad?, que tienen que estar en clases. Ese es el objetivo. Entonces, si tienen alguna situación, yo la voy a informar a la administración y ellos saben los canales para que conversen con ellos, ¿verdad? Pero en la medida de lo posible, traten de conectarse, porque aunque sea un ratito que estén en clase, eso ya cuenta. Recuerden que los minutos cuentan y se les suman, ¿verdad?, la determinada cantidad de minutos que ustedes van a estar en clase. Eso es con respecto a attendance. Cameras on, mute on. Tratemos de tener las cámaras encendidas, ¿verdad? Porque así vemos quién está, con quién podemos participar, con quién podemos practicar, porque a veces se queda congelado y si no tienen la cámara encendida, entonces nosotros creemos que ahí está y yo voy a estar. Ani, Miss González, y probablemente se quedó congelada la imagen, pero como no la estamos viendo, no nos damos cuenta, ¿de acuerdo? Entonces, tratemos de ser un poquito empáticos con esa situación. Microphones off. Los micrófonos apagados, ¿verdad? ¿Por qué? Porque, fíjense bien, que cuando estamos participando y todos están con el micrófono abierto, hay interferencias. Entonces, solamente cuando nos toque participar, por favor, ¿verdad?, vamos a tener el micrófono activado. Manners. Manners is regarding to modales. Okay, we're going to use netiquette. The dressing code. Remember that even though you are at home or in your offices, you need to wear as if you were in an English class. ¿De acuerdo? Fíjense que ustedes van a tener que pensar que están en un salón de clases y así nos vamos a comportar. So we're going to be respectful with our partners. Vamos a ser respetuosos con los compañeros y compañeras, ¿verdad? El vocabulario que vamos a utilizar tiene que ser acorde a un salón de clase. De igual forma, nuestra vestimenta. Y así sucesivamente. ¿De acuerdo? And the dressing code is what I was mentioning before about the way that you dress. Acerca de la forma en que vestimos. Es cierto que viene el verano y el calor se está poniendo un poquito más fuerte, pero vamos a tratar, ¿verdad?, en la medida de que estemos en clase, de vestir apropiadamente. Now we have evaluations and homeworks. You know that you have to explore every single day the platform, right? Ustedes saben que tienen que explorar cada día la plataforma e ir desarrollando las actividades que se asignan día por día. ¿Por qué? Porque al final de la semana yo necesito consolidar esas notas, ¿de acuerdo? Si usted lo va dejando, se le va a ir acumulando, acumulando y Dios guarde, no va a lograr salir a tiempo. Aparte de eso, cuando llevemos el 50% de la clase, ustedes van a tener un examen de medio curso. Entonces, todos los contenidos que vamos repasando día a día van a ser evaluados en ese examen. ¿Estamos claros? Entonces, para que usted practique teoría y práctica, entonces necesita hacer las prácticas de las plataformas. Ahí automáticamente se le va a ir consignando su progreso y su evaluación, ¿de acuerdo? Entonces, necesito que cada uno de ustedes vaya trabajando a diario en la plataforma. ¿Hay alguna pregunta hasta el momento? ¿Alguien ya accesó a la plataforma? ¿Sí? Perfecto, muy bien. Tienen los links y todo, ¿verdad? No hay problema hasta el momento. Excelente. Y al final del curso va a haber un examen final. Quiere decir que el penúltimo día de la clase, ustedes ya deben de haber hecho ese examen. ¿Por qué? Porque el último día, ese día yo tengo que revisar para que se les procese lo más pronto posible su promedio y también su diploma. ¿Estamos claros? Y así salimos a tiempo. ¿Preguntas o dudas hasta el momento? Do you have any questions so far? ¿No hay dudas? ¿No hay preguntas?
Bien, tengo una pregunta.
Sí, diga.
Con relación a si yo no puedo hacer la tarea al final de la clase, luego el siguiente día me puede afectar.
Sí, usted lo puede hacer. A lo que me refiero yo es que usted tiene que ir tratando de salir a diario. ¿Por qué? Porque si no se le va a acumular, ¿de acuerdo? Y estar el fin de semana haciendo todo lo de la semana lo va a sentir como que un poquito pesado, ¿verdad? Entonces, si en la medida que le sea posible, usted trate de ir saliendo, pero si por alguna razón, motivo de trabajo, tráfico o qué sé yo, algunas actividades que tenga usted que hacer, sí lo puede hacer el siguiente día. Pero yo le voy a ir monitoreando día a día lo que usted va haciendo, ¿sí? Y ahí tenemos la lección 1, 2 y así, ¿verdad? Sucesivamente lo que tienen que ir haciendo y desarrollando ustedes. Y si tienen problema, el siguiente día vienen y me consultan para yo poder aclararles las dudas y que lo desarrollen de la mejor manera posible. ¿De acuerdo?
De acuerdo, okay. Gracias.
Ok, perfect. Any other questions so far? ¿Alguna otra pregunta? ¿Alguien tiene la manita levantada? Ok, Azucena, Adam, Azucena.
Cada curso que terminamos o cada módulo que terminamos se da un diploma.
Si usted logra el 80% de la asistencia y la nota mínima que es 8 en todo el proceso, entonces sí se le entrega el diploma.
Porque hasta ahorita no nos han hecho llegar ninguno y somos ya el cuarto módulo.
Ah, probablemente es porque están en espera de la firma, pero sí se los van a hacer llegar, ¿verdad? Pero sí es por cada módulo que se procesa uno. Sí.
Nada, pero solo
si
para...
En el módulo 4, quiere decir que los otros 3 módulos anteriores ya los pasó y probablemente están en proceso. Recuerden que con la situación que estamos viviendo en el país, muchos procesos se retardan, ¿verdad? Porque no es lo mismo que estemos presencial en las diferentes oficinas, como estar haciendo trabajo remoto, ¿de acuerdo? Pero sí van a tener su diploma a su CENI.
Solo para abonar en lo que Ada está preguntando, en mi caso, Recursos Humanos, Ada, ya me hizo llegar a mí el link donde puedo descargar el diploma de los otros, el módulo 2 y el 3, yo ya pude descargar los diplomas. Entonces pregúntele.
Ah, perfecto.
Recursos Humanos o algo así.
Ok, consulten con Recursos Humanos porque lo que Melissa nos comenta es muy interesante. Quiere decir que han hecho la conexión no con ustedes personalmente, sino que con Recursos Humanos, ¿verdad? Sí, entonces consulten ahí con la oficina de Recursos Humanos para que les envíen el link y ustedes ya puedan descargar su diploma, ¿de acuerdo? Sí.
Ok, thank you.
Ok, perfect. Any other question? Are we clear? Yes. ¿Estamos claros y claras? Sí. Okay, now let's continue. Hay alguien en el waiting room. Karen Stephanie. Okay, se está uniendo Karen. Bien, vamos a seguir entonces con la actividad que tenemos por acá programada. And here we go. I'm sharing my screen with you, girls and boys. And here, the warming up, getting acquainted, as I was telling you, conociéndonos. The objective is to exchange personal information and perspective about the participation in class, about your participation in class, okay? So what are you going to be doing? You're going to be sharing personal information and your expectations for the class, right? So here we go. Let's see. Now I have 15 participants. Excellent. And people, what is it about getting acquainted? My name is Irma Carballo. Yes, I live in San Salvador. I am married. I have one son. And well, my favorite color is red. My favorite food is seafood. I like to go to the beach, but I prefer to go to the mountains. I like swimming. I am an English teacher and I work teaching classes for Inglés para el trabajo. Yes? My expectations about this class is that all my students practice the English language, participate actively, and all of my students pass to the next module, which is number 5. Okay, are we clear? What I said is what you are going to be doing with your partner. So right now you are going to be practicing language, your personal information, and what you do, the place where you work and what you do for a living, okay? Ustedes van a practicar haciendo lo siguiente, dando su información personal al compañero o compañera, diciendo su puesto de trabajo, lo que hacen y las expectativas para este curso. Luego vamos a compartir en general. Now let me see how many students do I have so far. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. In the meeting, 15. But with me? Yeah, 15 with the teacher, right? Okay. So you're going to move to the small rooms and you practice. Later, you get back to the virtual room and we share the information. Are we clear? Vamos a yo les voy a asignar con quién van a trabajar. Se van a los grupos pequeños. Yo les voy a estar monitoreando, voy a estar ingresando a los grupos de ustedes. Y cuando sea el tiempo de regresar, nos regresamos a este espacio virtual, a este salón virtual y voluntariamente van a compartir la información, no la de ustedes, la del compañero. So pay close attention about the information your partner is going to share with you. Okay? Questions? Preguntas? No questions. Okay, so here we go. Let me see. The breakout rooms. So I'm going to create 7 groups. And at random, okay? Automáticamente lo voy a crear para que se conozcan todos, ¿de acuerdo? Okay. Options. And okay. Now I am going to share a message with you, okay? Get into your group. Okay, you can go to your group. Pueden irse a su grupo. Ahí le llegó el mensaje. César. César lo voy a asignar a un grupo. Se van a presentar con sus compañeros, ¿ok? Van a decir su lugar de trabajo y las expectativas para este curso. Luego regresamos, ¿de acuerdo?
Ok.
Okay, I'm going to, good evening. Assigned to, okay. You're going to be in room number one.
Okay.
Únase porfa al grupo uno. Okay, perfect.
We are going to introduce ourselves. So,
yes,
if you want to start
about you.
Okay.
The victim.
Okay. Yes.
Okay. Hi, good evening, everybody. My name is Cesar Lopez. I am 35 years old. I am an industrial engineer, and I work in PIB Inversiones. I am a sales assistant, and I am happy with for starting the English class.
Okay. Remember that later you have to present his information, okay? You have to pay attention, Cesar, because you're going to give the information of another partner, okay?
Okay, okay.
Perfect. But Melissa, Cesar, yes. And Albert, okay? So you can continue. I'm going to move to another room.
Okay. Thanks.
It was the same deal, and that was stream, and then was the same converges, and now it's concentric. So I work for the concenter. I work for the concenter, and I work all my daily basis is speak in English, but I recognize that I'm missing a loving grammar. So that is the reason why I'm here, because I want to learn, and it doesn't matter if it's the basic, but I want to have a strong base. Uh-huh. And I don't have kids. I'm single and I live here in Santa Ana. I'm happy working from home.
Yeah. Oh, nice. My expectatives in the course, it's practice more English, but my day language, ¿cómo sería, teacher? Decir, que el lenguaje sea, que mi lenguaje o mi pronunciación sea más fluida.
Okay, my objective or my expectation is to get a more fluent pronunciation. Yes, okay. More fluent
more
pronunciation.
Fluent pronunciation, okay, thanks. Mm-hmm. That's all.
That's all, okay, thank you. And now you, Yolanda? Chris,
now me?
Yes. Did you practice before?
Okay. Yes. Yes.
So you are ready to present for the class. Yes?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So.
But if you want, I can repeat.
No, because you have to give his information and he is going to give your information for the class. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So make sure about details. Yes?
About details.
Yeah, about the details of the information.
Okay.
Because in 1 minute, we're going to get back to the. Okay, are you ready, girls? Good to see you, girls. Are you ready with your information? ¿Están listas con la información? Lorena. Going to share Xochitl's information, and Xochitl is going to share Lauren's information, okay?
Okay.
Xochitl nos va a platicar sobre la información de Lorena y viceversa, ¿de acuerdo? So,
okay.
Both of you practice, right? Ya practicaron, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Kind of. You say more or less?
Less.
Okay, okay. Continue
practicing. No. Yo, o sea, I...
You haven't practiced. You didn't practice.
No.
Okay, no. It's now the time for you to practice. Let's do it, because in 1 minute, we're going to get back to the room.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Practique, Xochitl, dele su información a Lorena, porque luego regresamos en un minuto al aula virtual.
Okay.
Okay, please.
Okay. Veamos.
Is rose.
No.
My favorite flower is rose. Can you?
Las azucenas, por supuesto.
Okay, in 1 minute we're going to get back, okay, to the virtual room.
Okay, thank you, teacher.
My pleasure. Get ready, girls. Okay.
Favorite music.
En Sonsonate.
Sonsonate, la ciudad. Sí,
Sonsonate.
Ajá.
Este.
¿Trabaja? Bueno, uno de.
Ajá.
Ruido. Ajá.
Cotegna, Acajutla.
Permítame. ¿Y qué puesto desempeña ahí?
Ah, operador de sistema.
Ajá.
¿Y usted, Freddy?
Pues and you, igual. Freddy?
¿Mande?
No, he asked you. And you, Freddy? ¿Y usted, Freddy?
Ah, okay. And you, Freddy? Hey, thanks.
Use the language.
Now I am asking him. Where he asking me.
Okay.
okay. Operator. El sistema.
El sistema.
Okay. And now, your food job.
A lot. Okay. And now you are ready to practice with the class. Yes? You share.
Yes.
¿Están listas para la clase?
Ready.
Okay. Ready. Here we go, girls. I'm going to close all the rooms and you get back to the virtual classroom, okay?
Okay. Okay. Thank you, Heidi.
Thank you, Karen.
Nos volvió a poner la teacher, ¿no?
No. Lo que pasa es que estamos esperando que regresen los demás.
Ah, pensé que solo nosotras dos estábamos.
No, ya estamos en el salón. Ya está regresando. Ok. Hello, welcome back. Thank you. The first girls were terrified because they said, oh my gosh. Okay, okay. Let's see. I need some volunteers in order to share. Just a few of you. Not all of you are going to participate, but some of you, okay? Volunteers to share to introduce the other partner. Hello, volunteers, voluntarios, para presentar al compañero o la compañera.
I'm here, Freddy Rivas.
Ana Gonzalez has raised her hand. Annie wants to begin. Okay, Ms. Gonzalez, begin introducing your partner.
Okay, good evening, everybody. I was with Veronica Enriquez. She works at Fusalmo. She works in the logistic area. She's a single mother. She has a girl. And she likes music. Watch TV, and also she wants to practice more speaking English. She lives in San Salvador in Soyapango, and she's working from home too.
Okay, she's doing home office right now. Very well. Excellent. Thank you. Let's clap because microphones are mute. So, excellent. Very well. Another volunteer, please. Hello.
Me.
Please. Hello. Karen. And after Karen, Freddy's. Okay. Karen.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
My partner is Heidi Salguero. She's 43 years old. She had three children, those two boys and one girl. She is married. She worked in the bank Cuscatlan. She is manager.
Wow.
Finish.
Congratulations. Very well. Excellent. Clap, clap, clap. Clap, clap, clap. Mute claps. Okay. Hey, congratulations. Excellent. Very well done. And now it is the time for a boy, Freddy's, Mr. Rivas Diaz. Okay. Please read your information.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. I want to present my partner. My partner was Hugo Ventura. He lives in Sonsonate City. He is working in Cotegna, Acajutla. He worked like an operator of system for the scanner. He prepared food, is a beef, chicken, and salad. Well, it was short time to ask him, but her expectation is practice English and grammar. Well, just that.
That's all.
Like, yeah, that's all.
Okay, very good. Excellent. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Another participant, please. Hugo, or who wants to share? Another participant? Okay. Oh, Heidi. Okay.
Good evening, everyone. Let me introduce you, Karen Stephanie Flores. She is 25 years old. Her favorite color is blue. She's an accountant. She works for Survive. I couldn't understand much well the enterprise, but she has no children, but she loves cats. She has four cats. The names are Kali, Leia, Perlita, and Mileto, I guess. She loves sleeping and reading novels.
And
she's
also
a very nice lady.
She's a cat lover. She's a cat, right? Yes, okay, very well. More information?
She lives with her parents, with her mom and her dad, and she has a little sister that's studying, and she has a boyfriend.
Oh my God, very good. Okay, thank you, congrats. Congratulations, very well done. Okay, clap, clap, clap. The last one, one more participant.
Me.
Okay.
Me. Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
I am introduced to Melissa Olivares. She lives in Santa Tecla City. She is married. She works in Distribuidora Salvadoreña. She is brand manager with a specialty on whiskey.
Okay.
She has two dogs. And she likes the sushi.
She likes to eat sushi very well. In other words, her favorite food is sushi. Excellent. Very well. Thank you so much. Excellent. Very, very well done. Okay. Now you know your partners, right? Okay. So we're going to have a general introduction. You introduce yourself, your name, the place where you live, and the place where you work. Yes? Okay, so everybody can get acquainted. Heidi, would you please be my guest? You begin. Hello, class. My name is blah, blah, blah. I live in and I work at or I work in. Okay?
Okay. My name is Heidi Salguero. I live in Antiguo Cuscatlán. And I work for Banco Cuscatlan for the last 25 years.
Oh my God, 25 years in there. You are an institution. Congratulations. Very good. Now, Heidi, you choose one classmate in order to continue with the exercise. Choose your victim, please.
Okay. I choose Lorena. Lorena.
Lorena, where are you, Lauren? Lorena? Oh, here.
Oh, here.
Because it used
I'm sorry, Lorena.
No problem. Hey, my classmate, Xochitl Marcela?
No, it is about you, Lauren. Now it is general information about you. Your name, the place where you live, the place where you work, okay?
So yo tengo que dar mi información.
Yeah, because it is in general, yeah.
¿La mía o la de mi compañera?
Your information, your name, okay. The place where you live, and the place where you work, okay?
Okay, my name is Lorena Cigarán. She is 46 years old. I live in Mexicano City.
So you live in Mexicano City, yes?
You live in, yo.
Yes, you say I live in Mexicano City.
I live in Mexicano City. I am married. I have my son. My favorite color yellow and black. I work of layer in municipality Mexicanos.
Okay. That's it. Thank you very much. Congratulations. Okay, now you, Lorena.
Pero no tengo audífonos.
Eso sí, no estoy
escuchando. Lauren, you choose the name of another classmate.
So,
yeah, you read the name of another partner to continue with the introduction.
Xochitl?
Xochitl.
Hi. Good night. Mi dato voy a dar ahorita, ¿verdad?
Yes, only your name, the place where you live and where you work.
My name is Xochitl Marcela Girón Abrego. I am pharmacist chemist. I work on lawyers. I am
ese televisor me estorba en mis clases.
Mexicanos.
Yo porque te veo en el teléfono.
I have one son.
I have one son. Okay, give me a second.
No, Mary.
And you're not married. Very good. You have one son and. You are not married. Okay, Milagro, would you please turn off your microphone? Milagro, ¿podría apagar su micrófono, Linda? Okay, okay, thank you. Thank you, Milagro. And now let's see, Xochitl, say the name of another partner.
¿Cómo se llama? ¿Dónde está? No la veo. Ah, Lorena Guadalupe.
Ah, she already participated. Say another name.
Hugo Ventura.
Hugo, where are you? Hugo, ah, over there. Ajá, Hugo, it is your turn to practice.
Okay. Okay. Good night. My name is Hugo Ventura. I live in Sonsonate City.
Yes.
I work in Cotecna Spectrum. I am work operator system. I have 14 years.
You are 40 years.
4 years, yeah.
Okay, thank you very much. Now, Hugo, you say the name of another classmate, please.
Okay.
Who has opened the mic?
Fatima.
Fatima, please. Go close the microphone, please.
Okay, okay.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
My name is Fatima Lopez. I live in Cuscatlán 5.
Okay.
I am a receptionist. I work at Nexa. My favorite food is pizza.
Pizza. Okay, very well. Thank you. Now you, Fatima, say the name of another classmate. You have Mr.
Cesar.
Oregon.
Cesar.
Cesar? Ah, but you already did it, right? Yes. Cesar? Ya participó, ¿verdad, Cesar?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Okay, now you, Cesar, say the name of another partner.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Andrew.
Andrew. Okay. Ana Perez. Go ahead. Be my guest. And he was like, please. Okay, go ahead.
Hello, everybody. Good night.
Good evening.
Good evening. My name is Andrea Orellana. I work in Santa Tecla. I live in Antiguo Cuscatlán, but my father's live in Soyapango, and I am travel with one day or week the Soyapango. My job is assistant administrative. Porque todólogo no lo puedo decir en inglés.
Multitasking. Multitasking.
Multitasking.
I am multitasking, you say that.
I am multitasking, tasking that. That's all.
Okay.
I like tenerlos de compañeros y verlos nuevamente a los que
okay. No veo. Okay, you stay. I'm happy to see you back. Okay. Yeah. Thank you. Now I'm going to choose the next participant, Milagro.
Yo ahí iba a decir también.
Ah, so you see? Communication. Milagro, you have to introduce yourself to the class. Tiene que presentarse a la clase. Say your name, the place where you live, and the place where you work. Okay? Please.
Good evening. Gracias, Andrés, por tenerme siempre presente.
Yeah, okay, you are always in his mind. Okay, go ahead.
My name is Milagro Hidalgo. I live in Mexicanos. I work in, I am business woman. Y bueno, estoy feliz de ver rostros happy.
Okay.
Andrés, César, Melissa, Fátima.
And the most important thing is
Azucena, Veronica.
Your friends are okay and they are alive. Yes. In these days, it is excellent to see happy faces. Yes. And that they are healthy. That's good. Excellent. And now who is missing? Help me. Melissa. Melissa, it is your turn.
Hi, good evening. My name is Melissa Olivares. I live in Santa Tecla City and I work in Distribuidora Salvadoreña.
Okay, excellent. Thank you. Who is missing? Veronica. Veronica Yesenia. You have to introduce yourself, miss. Your name.
Hi, the people.
And where you work, okay? Hi, welcome.
Hi, my name is Veronica Enriquez. Work in Fusalmo, alive Soyapango.
I live in Soyapango. Okay.
I live in Soyapango.
Excellent. Everybody's done. Alberto, did you introduce yourself? Alberto, did you practice this exercise? Okay, go ahead.
Okay.
Good evening, class. My name is Mauricio Ramirez. I live in Suchitoto City, and I am a pastor.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot. Everybody's gone? Too.
No, I'm missing.
Annie, okay, Annie, go ahead, please.
My name is Ana Claudia Gonzalez. I work for Concentrix. El Salvador is a call center in San Salvador, but I live in Santa Ana City. And I'm very happy working from home.
Yes, obviously. And
yes, because
traffic jam.
Yes. And I don't, I'm sorry, but I was connecting my computer because the battery was dying. Yes, I'm working from home and I'm happy because I'm sleeping. And that's it.
Okay, thank you so much. I appreciate your participation, people. And Ana Azucena, you already practiced, yes?
Okay. Good evening. My name is Ada Azucena Cáceres. I live in Mexicano City. I am a doctor. My favorite color is green. My favorite drink is coffee. And my favorite pet is a dog only.
Okay, very well. Thank you so much. Everybody's done, people? Yes. Oh, Veronica, tell me. Veronica, your hand is up.
No, no.
Okay, that's okay, perfect. So listen, it is 9 p.m., so I'm going to call your names for the second checking of the attendance, yes? And remember, when you listen to your name, you say here or you say present. Okay, let's see. Ada Azucena is here.
Present, teacher. Present.
Ana Claudia Gonzalez.
Here. Here, here, Ana.
Oh, yes. Because it changes the panorama. Andres Alberto is here. Cesar Humberto is here. Fatima, here. Delmira is absent. Freddy's, David, here,
I'm
right?
I'm here, I'm here.
Yes. Heidi, here.
Right here.
Hugo, yeah, here. Karen, Stephanie? Stephanie, Flores?
Here.
Here. Yeah. Liliana, Melissa? Liliana, here. Melissa, Olivar, out here.
I'm here. I'm here.
Yeah, I see you. I see you, Miss. Thank you. Lorena, yes, she is here. Milagro, here, yes. Mauricio Alberto?
I'm here.
Okay, thank you. Patricia Yanet, absent. Sandra Caroline, absent. Veronica Yesenia? Veronica?
I'm here.
Okay, here you are. Wendy, absent. Xochitl, here. Xochitl, yeah, I see you. And Yolanda,
here.
Okay, here. Perfect. Thank you. Okay, so all of you are working right now. So I'm going to share my screen with you, people. And here we go. Okay, let's continue. Now you're going to begin practicing more. And here we go. Oh, okay. Everybody, in your manual, please. Here, the idea is to describe different features about the products that my or someone else's workplace purchase. In my case, I think that my company, because it is an educational institution, they buy ink. They buy, they purchase paper to print, yeah, information. They buy maybe books, yes, okay. In my case, now later on, you're going to be working and you're going to be writing a list of some items, some articles, some things that you consider your company buys or purchases. Now here, ask some partners about all the products that their workplaces purchase and the features of it or the features of them. Remember, I told you features mean characteristics, yes? What are the characteristics of the things, the products that your company purchases, that your company buys, yes? And now you're going to work in small groups and you're going to write the products that your company purchases. In a bank, what do they purchase? What do they buy? Yes, paper, ink, paper clips. What else? Cleaning products, sanitizing products, and some others. According to the nature of your company, you're going to be writing a list and sharing with your partners. So right now I'm going to stop sharing and you're going to work in a small groups, okay? So right now I have 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 16. So you're going to work in groups of 4, yes? And here we go. Oh no, but here I already have the groups. Yeah, better in pairs, so it is faster. You're going to have only about 8 or 10 minutes because you're going to work in pairs. So you move to your groups right now and I'm going to open the rooms. You know the room you have to go, yes? Okay, and I'm going to send the message right now. Go to your breaking rooms, okay? And let me see, Yolanda, your group. Milagro, I'm going to assign you, okay? Milagro, you're going to move to room number 6. Okay, Milagro? And Yolanda, which was your group? Move to your group.
Number 3.
Okay, go to group number 3, Yolanda.
Okay.
Okay, perfect.
Hey, Biovid. How much money do you think they spend? A lot.
You have to write the list of products that they purchase. Okay. For example, cleaning paper, sanitizing, cleaning products, only the names and the characteristics that they have. Okay.
Okay.
For example, the characteristics or features, they must be high quality. Yes. And nowadays, because of the pandemic, hand sanitizer, maybe ammonium, yes?
Okay.
And the characteristics of those products, okay? I'm going to move to check other groups.
Okay.
Continue. But in your company, okay? Later, we're going to share.
Okay. So, Veronica.
Taya, mixture of proportion and some king.
Okay, remember that you have to write a list of the products that your company purchases. that your company buys. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. And later you share. And also the features. Features is a synonym for characteristics or details that the product must have. Because if they are a low or poor quality, you don't buy them, right? Okay, I'm going to join another group.
Teacher, that's the number. The number that's in the letter, yeah? Eso es lo que hay que poner.
No, 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 no. What you have to say, I told you, is to write a list of the products that your company purchases.
Okay. Ah, de nuestra compañía.
Compra.
Ah, okay.
And the characteristics or the features. For example, if they buy ammonium, must it be high quality? Or a liquid, or a concentrated. Yes? Si el amonio que compran es concentrado, o de qué, cuál es una característica de lo que compran. Yes? In your company. If they buy paper, ink, if they buy coffee, sugar, what do they buy?
Okay. Okay? Nice.
Okay, and but in your company and in the other company too. Okay.
Yeah.
So let me see. I'm going to join another group. Okay.
Okay.
Continue and remember that later you are going to share with the class.
Ver recursos.
Resources. Resources. Like human resources. Resources.
Estamos conversando sobre lo que nos, lo que cada uno está trabajando, ¿verdad?
Because both of you are doing home office. Las dos están haciendo home office.
Sí. Yeah. Bueno.
No.
Parcial. Yo okay. Parcial.
Okay, part-time. No. So listen, it is about your company in general. Yes? What does your company buy? For example, do they buy coffee? Do they buy sugar? Yes?
Yes.
Do they buy water?
Yes.
Okay, and the features or characteristics of those products that they buy. For example, if you say, well, in my company, they buy or they purchase water, bottled water, they buy coffee. It must be Jose Valdez, or it must be, you know, from the supermarket, or they have a special company that provides the coffee. Yes. Do they buy hand sanitizer? What is the characteristic or feature of the brand of the hand sanitizer that your company buys? Yes. Okay. So you write the list of the three or four products that your company buys. Okay, and that's it. Your company and your company. For example, at the city hall, they buy cleaning supplies. Yes?
Yes.
Cleaning supplies. They buy hand sanitizer. They buy cleaning paper. They buy also, how can I say? They also buy... they buy ink. Yes?
Ya me perdí.
The printers. Tinta para las impresoras. Yes or no? ¿Ya? ¿Su compañía qué es lo que compra, Xochitl?
Water, coffee.
Okay, yes. Uh-huh. Is it a good quality coffee? Because in some companies, it is poor quality for the employees, but in others, it is excellent quality. Yes? Okay, so that is what you have to share.
Es que estoy cero ahorita en la práctica.
Okay, no, but that is the idea that you practice. Okay.
At my company. Tienen.
They.
Tinta. How do you say? Tinta. The impresora.
Ink. Ink. I-N-K. Ink. Ink.
Teacher, purchases and buy es la misma, es el mismo término.
Yes, they are kind of synonym. Yes. Okay, one more minute and then we're going to start sharing, okay?
Okay.
Because you have to read your information with the class.
Okay.
I'm going to try this group. Okay.
¿Y esa tinta como para qué? De impresores.
Para las impresoras. Tenemos tres tipos de impresoras. La toner, una Canon normal y una donde
toner,
se...
Toner for printers.
Okay, so you say toner and ink. Printing ink.
Printing ink.
Printing ink.
Yeah, because the toner can also be used for the... for the copier machine.
For the,
yes?
Yes.
And be also, but especially
but I guess the
ink is especially for the multi-purpose, okay, the small ones and the scanner.
Yes, scanner, photocopy, impresiones.
I guess they use all of them.
Yeah, all in one. Many people have all in one.
Okay. We got both kinds at the bank.
Yeah, and I have seen at the bank that they have modern printers and scanners. They are very small, right? And they
two kinds.
Different types.
And the big one, the big one, the multifunction, and the small one.
Tiene, se puede imprimir como por de tres lados, algo así, pero para diferentes cosas y también.
And para... also with Bluetooth from the phone, right?
Sorry?
With the Bluetooth from the phone, they have the feature that you can print from your phone via or by means of YouTube, Bluetooth.
Yeah? Creo que no está configurada, sí, para nosotros.
No, because there are some machines that they have automatically that feature, that characteristic.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay.
In our case, it's very strange because what we purchase is service, so it doesn't have a size or dimension or battery life, right?
Okay, so in 1 minute, we're going to get back to the virtual room, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, it's ready, time flies.
Okay.
Dice, wait. Wait es peso, ¿eh?
You finish. Yes. Did you finish with the list? Yes? Are you ready to share? That is when you have to write only 5 products that your company purchases. That is the only activity. You don't have to do the other one. You're playing a trick. Okay, in 30 seconds, we're going to get back to the virtual room, okay? So get ready because you're going to share. Actually, right now, I'm going to close all the rooms so you can come back to the big room and we can share. Maybe you have some coincidences with other partners. Get back to the room. Okay, here we go. And now let's begin sharing. I need some of you to only read the products that your company purchases, usually purchases. One volunteer?
Me.
Okay, please. Heidi and later Yolanda.
Okay, the products we purchase are savings accounts, okay, checking accounts, mm-hmm, and mortgages, loans, credit cards, debit cards, a lot more.
A lot of products. Okay.
Thank you.
Well done. Congrats. Very well done. And now I said, Yolanda, where are you? Yolanda, you asked me to participate. Okay, Karen. Karen, raise your hand, please. Go ahead, read your information.
Okay. In company work, offer accounting service, auditing service, tax report, bad boot, legalization of book, and tax returns.
Yes, those are the services that your company provides to the people. But what do they purchase in order to give those services to the people? Do they buy ink? That's it.
Paper, printing ink. We had special paper in continuous paper, electricity and water. No sé cómo se dicen sellos.
Seals. Uh-huh. Okay. That's all. Thank you so much. Congratulations. Well done. Well done. Freddy, want to participate?
Thank you. So first, I want to explain you. I'm working for the Cotec now. This is for a scanner. Now we give a service for the scanner for the Advana. Okay. Now we are a service company. We usually buy blank paper, toner for printer, a sanitation product, toilet paper, a spare part for scanner, oil, grease for the maintain, and a product for the cafeteria for employment. Just that.
Okay. Very well done. Congrats. Excellent. Someone Thank else? You. Another participant? Okay. Maybe Albert, Cesar, who wants to participate? Come on, people. You have to participate. Milagro?
Oh, hi.
Okay. Okay. Cesar and later. Okay. Later a lady. Okay. Cesar, begin, please.
Oh, okay. In my company, we offer industrial equipment such as chain and cable hoist, electric and combustion forklift, industrial shearing, industrial and construction elevators, and spare parts.
Okay, mm-hmm. Thank you. Very well. Congratulations. Excellent. And another girl who was volunteering, who wants to participate? One more lady? Okay, Veronica.
The foundation work with projects and with boys. The logistics transportation, import Porsches, ¿cómo se dice? Como por ejemplo, example is the toilet paper, floor cleaners, sanitation help. Solamente.
Okay, thank you very much. Excellent. Congratulations, people. Boys and girls are working very well. And right now, we're going to go over the next exercise that some of you were, you know, taking advantage because some of you were working on it. But let's try to do it together here. And you have this in your manual. Okay. Let's match the different features on a product with its definition. Later, we're going to compare with a partner. Try to do it individually, and later we're going to share here with the class. We have the feature and we have the definitions here. Size, weight, price, dimensions, battery life, storage, function, warranty. Okay, please repeat after me. Size, weight,
price,
dimensions,
battery life,
storage,
warranty.
Excellent. Now, please close your microphones and begin matching. Size, you have to read the definitions that you have to your right hand side and match to the features that you have in numbers, okay? Close the microphones, please, everybody, so you can be focused, okay? Thinking about this. I'm going to give you 1 or 2 minutes and then we're going to discuss to check out whether we are in the correct size, okay? If you have any question, please don't hesitate and ask me, okay? Remember the features or characteristics: size, weight, price, dimensions, battery life, storage, function, warranty. As soon as you are done, you tell me, okay? You let me know, please. Then we begin the comparison. Okay, only this exercise. Number two. Remember, you have it in your manual, okay?
Don't. Only exercise number two. As soon as you get ready, please tell me. Two more minutes. Let's see. Let's read the definitions. Measurements of or proportions of some kind. A promise to repair, replace something within a period of time. Letter C. Battery performance and longevity. A thing's overall dimension or magnitude, the space available for retention of something, a body's relative mass, or the quantity contained by something. Letter G, the amount of money required or paid for something. Letter H, practical use or purpose in design. Okay. So somebody said that he is ready. Do I have another student? Yes.
Yes.
I'm okay. Ready.
Here we go. Let's see. If I say letter A, measurements or proportions of some kind that belongs to?
For me, number one, size.
What do you think, people? Do you agree? Partially agree? Or disagree?
For me, is size.
Okay, measurements or proportions of some kind.
Mm. For me, is size.
For me, is dimensions.
Measurements or proportions of some kind. Okay. So, number one.
Number one.
For me,
dimensions, number four.
Letter A goes to?
A.
Number?
Number four.
Number four.
Number four.
Okay, for number me. Four dimensions, because it is measurements in general, medidas.
Medidas.
Or proportions, yes, of some kind. Now, number two, weight. Weight. What is it?
For me, H, warranty.
F.
F.
For me, letter F.
Letter F. A body's relative mass or quantity. The quantity contained by some.
Good. A body's relative mass or the quantity contained by something. Excellent. Number three, price. What is it?
G.
G.
G, the amount G. of money required or paid for something.
Okay. G, letter G.
Price, letter G. Okay, letter G, price. Letter G, this one. Price. The amount of money required or paid for something. Something. Now, dimensions we already said, yes? Battery yeah. life. Yeah. What about battery life?
C? Letter C?
Letter A?
Letter C?
C.
Letter C.
Okay, letter C.
Letter C. Yes.
A measure of battery performance and longevity. Yeah? Letter C is battery life. Letter C, battery life.
Now,
storage. What about storage? Storage?
Storage, letter
E.
The space available for retention.
B, letter D.
B.
E.
E. E as an echo.
E as an elephant. Ah, oh, storage. The space available storage. For retention of something.
Something. Okay.
What about function?
H.
H.
H. Practical use or purpose in design. And what about the last one? Warranty.
Warranty. Letter B.
A promise to repair.
Letter D.
Replace.
Replace something within something. A period of time.
Excellent. A promise to repair, replace, something within a period of time. Very good. Okay. Now we are in agreement. We agree. Now we're going to ask the questions to a partner and write down the information. We're going to model the activity with one of your classmates. And that is what you're going to do. Okay. You're going to interview a partner. Heidi, I'm going to ask you, Heidi, how many products does your company workplace buy? It is approximate, okay?
How many do we buy?
Uh-huh, the company.
Those are a lot of things.
Okay, yes, but just tell me about
searches, such as security paper.
No. Only tell me the amount. How many? How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 products. How many products?
Hundreds, maybe.
Okay, very well. Hundreds. Which ones are they? Which are those products that they buy?
That we buy security paper, software programs, furniture and equipment, electricity. There are a lot.
Okay, thank you so much. Now, approximately how many units do they buy of it? Let's imagine.
How many units? Uh-huh. Let's imagine.
Mm-hmm.
About 1,000 computers, for example.
Okay, very well. The next question. How much money do you think they spend buying those products? How much money? Use your imagination. Approximately, how much money?
$50,000.
$50,000.
Tell me an amount, but I really don't know.
Okay, it is an approximation, okay? But I'm telling you, is it per month or per year? Or per week?
Per year, maybe.
Per year. Okay, very well. Did you listen to, I'm going to stop sharing because now it is your time. Okay, so people, did you notice what was the activity? Now it is your turn, okay? You're going to interview one partner. And you're going to ask those questions that are below the exercise. And I'm going to give you a couple of minutes. For example, how many of the products or how much products, blah, 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 and you give the specifications as I did with Heidi, okay? When you finish asking your partner, your classmate is going to ask you, okay? Ready for the pair work? Let's go to the breaking rooms. I'm going to open them. So go to your breaking rooms right now, very fast. Go to your breaking rooms.
She is just waiting for something.
Veronica?
Yes, she just is making something for a minute.
Ah, okay, so let's practice then.
Okay.
I'm going to ask you.
Okay.
Miss, which are the products that your company buys? How many products? Which are those products?
My company buys headsets. Because they broke a lot.
Oh, yes, I can imagine.
Uh-huh. They also purchase computers. They also purchase, I got confused. I don't know if CPUs or UPS name, the batteries that goes to the computer. I don't remember if UPS or CPUs, but those little box.
Okay, the UPS.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes.
And the, how many products? I think that maybe they purchase 1,000. Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And how much do you think that they spend in those products?
It could be $25.
Only $25.
I think it's a proxy, I don't know.
And
$1 million.
The computers. Oh my gosh, very, very cheap.
Yes. $1 million, let's say $1 million.
Probably a year.
Ah, yes, of course.
$1 million a year, yeah?
Yes, yes, okay, that's
maybe,
correct.
Maybe, yeah, because they need to be updating the...
correct.
You know?
The equipment.
Equipped, yeah?
Yes.
Material that... employees used to work the equipment.
Exactly.
Okay, Veronica, are you back? Veronica Yesenia, no, not yet.
Not yet.
Okay.
She was asking for some 2 minutes because I don't know.
Okay.
She was taking something.
She was in a hurry, so I'm going to stay here with you while she gets back because you don't have to be alone.
Ah, okay.
Okay, now you ask me the questions.
Okay, how many products does your workplace buy and which ones are they?
Well, they buy, I think, a lot of products. For example, computers, mm-hmm. Headsets, yeah, sometimes microphones. Mm-hmm. Screens.
Ah, okay.
Uh-huh, to project the classes, to share with the students. You know, in the other type of classes, the regular ones that mm-hmm. we used to have person to person. And, well, markers.
Markers.
Yeah, ink, erasers, desks, also cleaning paper, coffee.
Hi, coffee.
Yeah, sugar. Well, no things, right? Memories yes. that we have about our past life. Yeah. Okay, next question.
Approximately, how many units do they buy of them?
Probably computers, about, let me see, 50 computers per year, maybe, yeah. because they need to be updating the equipment, right?
Ah, okay, okay.
And the screens maybe 5 or 10 per year.
Okay.
Okay, because they have a specific period of lifetime. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, so that's why. And let's see, coffee, a lot of coffee, a lot of sugar. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And but do you think, for example, it says approximately how many pounds do you think
sugar
of coffee or sugar they buy?
Well, I don't know. Usually, well, they used to buy a lot. Approximately, I would say more than 100 pounds.
Wow.
Yes.
Per month or per year?
Maybe per year, but people drink a lot of coffee, Miss.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
And people are coffee lovers. Yes,
me. And how much money do you think they spend?
I don't know, but I think they must have a budget about $10,000, maybe. $10,000.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
It is not that much, but they need to be investing, I think.
Sure, okay. Yes, we don't know. We are not sure.
Yes. Veronica, are you back? Veronica, are you back? No, she's not.
No, she's not. But okay. Don't worry. If you need to go to another room, I'm going to stay here when she comes.
No, the thing
back
is that we need to get back to the virtual room. Yeah, because it is time.
It was so quickly. Ah, okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, did you practice? Yes. Okay, now you are going to report what your partner told you, okay? For example, if I say, well, Anna told me that in her company, they buy a lot of headsets because employees usually break them, yeah? Because they have to use the headsets every day for more than 10 hours sometimes, every day, right? And they buy $1 and some other things, right? Now you have to share with the class what your partner told you, okay? So, volunteers?
Hi.
Okay, Ada?
My company is a small company and divided into the 10 departments and is included in the recession, resources, human, the sales, and the countdown and the licitation. And my company is specialization in the supplies and products for surgical catheterization and for minimal invasive surgery for human. Mm-hmm. And the money is
a lot of money.
a lot of money,
too much money.
And the, ¿cómo se dice? Honorarios.
And the but why do you mean by the salary?
The salary is approximately $1 million.
No, you say the budget.
The budget. The budget.
Oh. Okay, budget, presupuesto.
Presupuesto.
Yeah, it is not honorario. It is the amount of money that they have, especially for those purchases. It is a budget that they have. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you very much. But remember that you have to report what your partner told you. Tienen que reportar lo que dijo el compañero o compañera. Freddy wants to participate. Mr. Rivas Diaz, please.
Yes, thank you. I interview Hugo Martinez. He worked in Cotegna. Well, he said, I asked him how many products his company bike is approximately 30 products. How many units is 10 units per month. But he explained me that they spend a lot of money for a spare part for a scanner. This is very, very expensive, but they have inventory in air. Their bike, the spare part, they use it, they have to bike again. And now, how many money? He says for operator in the seat in the in her company is in every area, every city is like around $400 a month.
But okay,
that's the most purchase mm-hmm. is in the spare part for scanner.
Yeah. Okay, good. The only thank you so much. Great. Yeah. But remember that we say how much money. When we talk about money, we say how much. We don't say how many, because we use how many when you can count the things, yes? The objects, animals, or people. But for money, you say how much. Thank you, Freddy's. One more participant.
Thank you.
One more participant. My gosh, nobody. Oh my God. So I'm going to choose according to the list. Get ready, everybody. Okay, Yolanda is volunteering. She saved you people. Okay, Yolanda.
Okay, thank you, teacher. My partner said he purchases about wipers and they buy two big bags on the moms. And he said about how much do they spend. He says I spend about $10 to the month. That's okay.
$10 per month or $10 a month. Okay, thank you. Very well. The last one. Now, yes, the last one. Who wants to participate? Nobody wants to share. I'm going to cry. Nobody. I'm going to interview you tomorrow.
Me.
Because of the time. Who wants to?
Me, Melissa.
Okay, Melissa, please. Thank you.
Well, Cesar told me that they buy about 25 products per month. Those products are papers, hoists, pallets, spare parts, industrial shelving, and the units that they approximately use or they approximately buy is 15 boxes of paper, 5 hoists, about 20 spare parts, 3 shelving, 20 pallets, and he thinks that they spend $20,000 per month.
Really, a lot of, yeah? Okay, thank you. Congratulations, very well done. And now let's see, I'm going to share my screen with you. We almost finished, but anyways, we have to take advantage of the time. And here we go. Okay, using countable and uncountable nouns. Tomorrow we're going to go deeper into that. But here we have the expressions that you have been practicing. How much and how many. You have this info in your manual. And then we have how much and how many. I need one volunteer in order to read the information in this box. Who wants to read this information? Only read. Okay, Yolanda, please. Okay, the thing is that I can't move it because I have it in here. Okay, do you have it at page 10 in your manual? How much?
I have it in paper if you want.
Okay, please.
Okay, how much? How much does the refrigerator weigh? How much does it cost? How much is the warranty? How much does it storage?
Very well. So you see in these cases, we use how much. How much does the refrigerator weigh? Yes, we don't say how many. We say how much. How much does it cost? About money, about prices. How much is the warranty? How much does it storage? And now, how many? Who wants to read the information, the sentences for how many? One volunteer?
I do.
Please.
How many? How many features does it have? How many colors is this in? How many functions does it have? How many products do you want?
Very well. So how many features does it have? 2, 3, 4, or none, because you can count them. How many colors is this in? Only in 2 colors. You can count the colors that that product is in. How many functions does it have? 5 or 10, you count the functions. How many products do you want? Only one or just 3, yeah? In other words, we use how many with the things, objects, animals, and people that we can count. If I say, how many students do I have so far? I can count my students, yes? Okay. And we use how much when you cannot count the item or what you are asking for, especially for money and mass nouns, the big ones. Now let's try to complete the following questions using how much or how many, considering the information that we have in these 2 boxes. Let's complete exercise number 5. Is it how much or how many for number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6? Okay, let's do it, please. You read the sentence, analyze it, and you insert the expression how much or how many. Later, you share with the class to check out. Okay, people, let's see. Number 1, pieces do I need to assemble this? Is it how much or how many?
Is how many. How many?
Very well, excellent. How many? Because it is plural. Pieces do I need? Yes, so it is How many? What about number two? How much?
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 Congrats, because it is about price. It is about money. What about number three? Okay.
How many?
How many?
How much?
How much?
How much?
How much is the battery life? Yes. Number four.
How many hours?
Excellent. Number six. I'm sorry, number five.
How much?
Excellent. How much money? Number six.
How many?
Because it is gallons.
How many gallons of water?
Very well. So that's it. Did you find any problem with that?
No problem.
Okay. Now let's do the wrap up, and after that, we're going to check the attendance for the third time. Okay. But let's see. Okay. What activities did we practice in class today? What did we practice in class today?
How much and how many?
Very well. Countable and uncountable phrases. Did you practice speaking?
Yes.
Is listening to your partner?
Yes, we practice.
Did you practice reading?
Yes, we did.
Did you practice writing?
Yes.
Okay, very well. So you practice today the four skills in order to acquire a language, in order to learn the language. And the last one, tell me, the grammar structure studied in class today was? What was the grammar structure?
How many, how much?
Excellent, very good. Countable and uncountable nouns. How much and how many? Okay, I'm going to stop sharing my screen and I'm going to call your attendance. Ada, Azucena? Ada? It's not here. Ana Claudia?
Hola, aquí estoy.
Okay, perfect. Andres is not here. Andres Alberto? Here.
Yeah.
Cesar?
Here, present.
Fatima? Fatima is not here. Fredis is
present.
Here.
Okay. Present and here.
Very well. Heidi Eugenia?
Here.
Okay. Hugo?
Present.
Okay, excellent. Karen Stephanie?
Present.
Liliana? Melissa?
Vamos.
Present.
Vamos ya.
Lorena Guadalupe?
Here, teacher.
Okay. María Milagros? Not here. No. Mauricio Alberto, not here. Patricia Yanet absent. Sandra Carolina? Verónica? Yesenia?
Present, teacher.
Wendy? Xochitl?
Present.
Yolanda? Miss Yolanda?
Present.
And Lorena, did I mention? Oh, yes. Okay, people, thank you so very much. I hope to see you tomorrow at 8. Let's try to be on time so we finish exactly on time. And remember to explore the platform, go over the exercises, and the structure is how much and how many. If you have any questions, you ask me tomorrow. Tomorrow we're going to work deeper. Vamos a trabajar más sobre esa estructura, okay? Have a good night. And dream with
good night, teacher.
Good night.
Bye.
Sweet dreams.
Bye. Thank you.
My pleasure.
Bye.
See you tomorrow. Bye. Take care. Bye.
No, la cagué, hombre.
Hello, close your microphones. close your microphones. Bye bye, Freddy is laughing from one side to the other one. Okay, bye bye. You have to say goodbye so I can finish the recording. Cuando se desconecten, voy a dejar de grabar. Bye bye, Lauren. Bye bye, Ada. Bye bye, Hugo. Lorena, bye bye. Hugo, close your microphone and bye bye. Bye bye, Hugo. Hugo, bye. Hugo, bye bye. Bye bye, Hugo. Okay, perfect.